So good to see you again. How are you? I wanted to talk a little bit today about Epiphany. So we've been in this season for a few weeks now. You'll notice we're in green, we were in blue, and then we were in white. Now we're back in green because it's right now in the church is the season after the Epiphany. And I think we've talked about this before. The Epiphany was when the wise men made it all the way to the manger where baby Jesus was. And the child God, right, the Christ child, was revealed to men who were not Jewish. And so that's kind of symbolic of how Jesus can be for everyone in the world, not just people who have come to the faith by birth, but by anyone who stumbles upon the goodness of God, right, who it's revealed to. That's the Epiphany, this great revelation. I'm sure sometimes you have great ideas, right? You have epiphanies like, oh, that would be great. Do you know what goes really well together? Peanut butter and bananas on sandwiches. The first time I had that, true epiphany. So today, I want to talk to you a little bit about how you might be an epiphany for other people. And what that means is you can be a light for Jesus Christ in the world. You can, by your example, by what you do, and by your words, by what you say, reveal Jesus and the goodness of God to other people, to your friends, to your family. And that requires some thought. So how do you think you might act like Jesus this week? What might you do? Might you tell someone that you enjoy their company? That you appreciate something good about them? Maybe they're always nice to someone who doesn't often have people be nice to them. Could you pick up after yourself? Is responsibility part of acting like Jesus? Could you open a door for someone? Could you say thank you and please? Could you tell people you love them? Could you throw someone's trash away who left it on the floor? What else could you do that would be like Jesus? Go ahead, you can answer. Talk to whoever's around you about it. What would you do to be like Jesus this week? Very good. Now I want you to take whatever you talked about or thought about and do it, because then you can be an epiphany for others. And the light of Jesus and the message of Jesus and the life of Jesus can be known more in the world because of you. All right, let's have a prayer, and then off to chapel you go. Jesus, we thank you for being known to us, for revealing yourself to us, and for giving us time and space to act more like you and to speak more like you and to be more like you. We hope that you always are made known to us and to those around us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, off to chapel you go.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to Children's Chapel. The first thing we have to do is sing Jesus Loves Me.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes. Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Thanks for joining me in that song. Now that we sing Jesus Loves Me, it's time to listen to our story. So let's put our listening ears on and we'll listen to our story.
Mark chapter 4, verses 35 through 41. Jesus calms the storm. That day, when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him."
What a great story! Now that we have sang our first song and listened to our story, it's time to talk about our pows and our wows. Remember, a pow is something sad or something we're upset about that we want to pray about, and a wow is something good or something happy that we want to pray about. So during this time, I want you to pause me and talk to your mom, your dad, or your guardian about your pows or your wows from this past week. And then once you've done that, unpause me and we'll pray about those things. So while you talk to your mom, your dad, or your guardian, I'll just wait right here. It's the Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. Come inside. Oh, are you guys done? I was just singing the Mickey Mouse Clubhouse song with Mickey. Mickey Mouse Clubhouse is my daughter's favorite show, and we watch it all the time. So I know all the songs from Mickey Mouse Clubhouse, and I love Mickey. Now that you have finished telling your mom and your dad about your pows and your wows, let us pray about those pows and your wows. So remember, when we pray, we take our hands, we fold them together, we close our eyes, and we bow our heads. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for all my friends who decided to join me. I am so excited that they are all here and I cannot wait to see them again. We pray that you keep our hearts and our minds focused on you, and we pray that you've heard all of our pows and our wows and know the songs of our hearts. May we continue to keep our hearts focused on you. In your name we pray. Amen. Now that we have sang our first song, read our story, said our Children's Chapel Creed, and prayed for our pals and our wows, it's time to do our final last thing, which is sing This Little Light of Mine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no! I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no! I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no! I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Don't let Satan it out, I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan it out, I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan it out, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Shine it around the whole wide world, I'm gonna let it shine. Shine it around the whole wide world, I'm gonna let it shine. shine it around the whole wide world. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Thank you for joining me in that song. You guys are always such wonderful, good singers. I'm so glad you decided to join us today, and I cannot wait to see everyone again next week. Bye, guys.
Welcome back. I hope you had a great time singing and listening to the story. And I hope this week that you will remember to find ways to be like and speak like Jesus. See you later.